sweetheart, where are you tonight? I need your caress to console me, my dear. Oh, sweetheart, where are you tonight? I'd go where you are, no matter how far. Won't some guiding star guide me right? My heart, lonely heart, seems to call, can't you hear? Oh, sweetheart, where are you tonight?
Sure, good to hear your voice over the phone again. When'd you get in? Uh-oh. I mean get out.
About an hour ago.
Boy, when am I going to see you?
I tell you, I'm going over to see the boys first. And, I tell what you do. You grab a cab and meet me over at Tommy's place in, say, about a half an hour.
I'll be waiting for you. And this is going to be an impatient moment till she gets her arms around you, big boy.
Okay, babe. Well,
bye-bye. That's you, 4789. Come on, I'm going to take a snappy now. Hurry up. That's you, 7489. Hurry up, Tim. Make it snappy, will you, please? Make it snappy. Cut out that noise. Cut out that noise.
Center, please.
Central, you gave me the wrong number.
Sorry, I will return your money.
Thank you. Thank you.
On sight. Grab him, men!
Who is it, Captain?
Let's take the sheik after him.
How many cards?
Give me two.
One, two. How many?
I'll play these.
Say, any of you guys heard from Nick?
No, do you think he'd phone the moment he got out? What do you suppose is keeping him?
He ought to have been here an hour ago. You suppose some of Smokey's gang has got him?
The chief? He's too smart for that.
I didn't do anything! Which way did he go?
Up the alley there, boys! Come on!
I'd like to lay my hands on this guy.
What's that?
You? Who?
Anybody home? Huh? Trying to give us a scare.
Well, you sure have the scare thing.
Yes. You look great. Hello, I'm glad to see you, Chief.
Say, what's the matter? You come in the back way instead of the front. Are you at the cops after you already?
Yes, I just fooled them. You know, I hate policemen anyway, don't you?
Up to your old tricks again, huh? Trying to kid the gang. Well, how'd you like the new joint?
Why, this is dandy. Do you live here all the time?
Sure, sit right down, Chief.
Make yourself comfortable, Chief.
Well, Dick, we're going to have some refreshment furnished by Smokey's gang, only they don't know it.
Here's a cigar, Nick.
There you are, Nick.
Atta boy.
Ah, me.
Pick him up!
And keep him up.
Well, here I am, boys. Say, one of Smokey's gang tried to plug me. And he nearly got me, too. Well, ain't you glad to see me back?
Sure, both of you.
What do you mean, both of you? What's the matter, you drunk? Say, don't you know Nick the Sheik?
Say, if you're Nick the Sheik, who's the guy in there?
What guy?
This fella here.
Say, your face looks familiar.
Yes, I seen your face too.
What's the idea of you trying to impersonate me? What's your name?
My name is Vernon Snodgrass. I'm a collector of rare coins.
What kind? Nickel and dime?
Say, Chief, I think he's a stoolie from the district attorney's office. Let's frisk him and see if he's got a rod on him.
If you mean a golden rod, I haven't any. It gives me hay fever. Now, cut the wisecracks. You know what happens to guys like you that butts into other fellows' business? Ain't I sorry? Ain't I?
I meant no harm. I didn't mean it, I tell you.
Oh, I'm shot. I'm shot. I'm shot. I'm shot. What did you do it for?
Must be for you, Nick.
Nick, take a tip from me and... Smokey O'Brien. So they're going to take me on an automobile trip. Don't you like automobile riding? I do. Why, a friend of mine asked me to go for an auto ride. Being big-hearted, I'll let you take my place.
Chief, let me go instead.
No, let me go.
A promise is a promise, and he promised me first. Very well, you shall take the ride. Is it an open or a closed car? Well, you'll start out in an open one and probably wind up in a closed one. A nice, big, black, shiny one. I can hardly wait, though. When do I go? Well, you can start right now. You just walk down to the corner, and someone will come along and talk to you, and you tell them you came for the ride, and they'll know what you're talking about. Ah, shucks, that'll be a lot of fun. Well, goodbye.
Another headline for the morning papers.
Hey, Smokey. There's Nick now.
Come on, boys. Let's get in.
area. I'm so sorry. Come on, hop in.
Hey, he's gone down to his dame's joint.
Good. We'll pay him a little surprise visit. What could be sweeter?
Gee, but it's good to see you again. Just think, it's been 5 years. Gee, but you look so different. Maybe it's these funny prison clothes.
They're neat, but not gaudy.
Boy, how I love you. Driver, back to my apartment, please.
Any excitement in this town
since you left. Make yourself right at home, Nick. Let me have your clothes, darling.
Oh, shucks.
Come on, give them to me. Darling. Sonny boy.
Mammy.
Maybe she got tired waiting. So you stay here and tell her I've gone to our apartment in case she shows up. Get me?
All right, Chief.
Poor boy. I know you're still dazed thinking of that terrible place you came from. But I'm going to make you forget. You're the bread and I'm the butter.
You're the steak and I'm the onions.
And you're the ham.
And I'm the egg. And put them all together, they spell...
What?
Mother.
Who's that?
Are you married?
The cops are Smokey's gang. Quick, hide. Not in there. In there. Quick.
Come on, open up.
Say, what's the idea? Who's been here? Now, come on, come on. Speak up.
Well, what? Are you twins?
Now, you're not going to tell me, huh? Well, we'll soon find out. Achoo! So he's in there. Come on out of there.
I will not.
Come on out of there. So it's you, eh? Say, what are you doing in there?
Believe me or not, but I'm not waiting for a streetcar.
Who is it? Somebody
in the cabin. Open up quick. Listen, Chief. Smokey and his whole gang on the way over here to get you. You better duck quick.
Smokey and his gang are gonna get me. Well, I'm not running. Let them come. We'll give them the works. Who is it?
It's me, Mr. Smokey O'Brien.
This town is too small for both of us. So you and your gang are leaving right now, or else we fight it out. Winner take all. Do you get me, Nick?
Well, I'm staying right here and I ain't going. Do you get me, Smokey?
Okay, boy. Here we come.
Please remember, I'm neutral.
I got that hat. Look out! Look out!
You're not so tough.
You
louse!
Take that!
Oh, sweet brother! I'm getting mad!
I didn't mean it!
I'm very happy, and I wish everyone could be as happy as we are.
Take things as they come to you.
Louder.
So take things as they come to you, summer, spring, or fall. Life is just a crossword puzzle, after all. Did you ever stop to figure, stop to worry, stop to guess whether life is just a treasure or a flop?
Just a minute. Cameras aren't going. All right, turn them over.
Now?
Okay.
Did you ever stop to figure, stop to worry, stop to guess whether life is just a pleasure or a fluff? We all start out to guess, each looking for success. But there's Did you ever stop to worry, stop to figure, stop to guess whether life is just a pleasure or a fluff? We all start out together, each looking for success. But there's very few of us who reach the top.
Did you tear anything?
Everything. I'm so sorry, Mr. Sherman.
Shall we try it again?
No, I've seen enough to satisfy me.
You don't think that was good?
Perfect.
I'm glad somebody in Hollywood recognizes talent.
Oh, isn't that wonderful?
Where do we sign the contract?
Right through that door.
Oh, thank you, Mr. Sherman.
Don't mention it. I'll be right with you.
All right. Joe Dilksy, delicatessen. Let me do the talking. We won't take less than 500 a week.
Thank heaven, no more tramping the streets. Well, I'll be.
Al? Thank you. We'll see you, Al. Hey, come back here.
Hey, what do you think you're doing?
Well, I'm looking for Marge Clancy. My sweetheart from Piperville.
She don't work here. Scram.
I wonder if Joe Dilks will still marry you.
I wouldn't bet on the way we treated him.
Big smile. Maybe Paramount Studio.
You're not taking them trucks until you pay the rent.
We send you the money from Piperville.
Upon the receipt of which, I'll send the trucks from Hollywood. We can't go home without baggage. Oh, if I could only get a job.
Well, phone them once more.
What's the use?
Quiet, idiot.
Hollywood 2, 400.
Casting director speaking. I don't place the name.
Marge Clancy, don't you remember? Did you ever stop to figure, stop to worry, stop to guess?
Oh, yes. Life is just a crossword puzzle after all. Say, I've got a job for you. Be here tomorrow morning at 9 o'clock. Did you get it? 9 o'clock.
Wake up! What did they say? Tell me. What happened?
Burn them up in the back a little. Yeah. All right. On the left there. Yeah. Give me a little more. That's right. That's good.
Now, Mr. Thompson, this is the big love scene in the picture. You enter, you throw your arms around her, and you kiss her with forever.
For what?
With forever, you know, with love, emotion, feeling.
Okay, I got it. Yeah.
So have I. I knew she had the makings of a star.
Hit her with a baby, Joe. Let's hit that broad in the back. Hit them all. Turn to the right, Miss Clancy, and look off.
Off where?
Just off. Now to the left. Thank you. Now turn your back on the camera. Make that back spot hot.
Ooh.
Okay for lights, Chief.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
That's all, Miss Clancy. Step aside. Mr. Villa. Please, they're ready now. Mr. V, you'll simply look wonderful this morning.
But I thought that
clear
I...
Clear the set, please.
Well, who is that girl? I thought I was going to act in this scene.
Don't worry, sister, you will when the rough stuff starts.
Rough stuff? What's that?
Why, she's Mr. Veer's double, ain't she?
Double? What does that mean?
That means that Mr. Veer gets $5,000 a week and you get $5 a day.
My phone McGrew.
Your gangster lover.
You killed him.
He can dish it out, but he can't take it. Now you'll get yours.
Oh, but Muscle, we weren't doing anything.
And you won't from now on. Okay, cut. That was very delightful, Mr. Veal. Now, shake her up good. Make it look real. Put something into it. All the cameras, turn them over. You double crossing. Out of my life forever. You please keep off my bed.
But you're trying to kill my daughter. Oh, are you all right, dear? Yeah, I guess so.
Now, everybody, come on. You go outside to the location scene, Doc.
Everybody, snap in it. Outside, come on.
Well, thank heavens. These lights are simply wearing me out.
Hey, wait a minute. Where do you think you're going?
Why, we have a luncheon engagement with Marilyn Hinckley and Freddie Marsh.
You and who else? Oh, I beg your pardon, Mr. Chaplin.
Oh, that's all right. Everyone makes mistakes. Spread ahead, Al. Charlie's getting hungry.
Okay. Good. Hold on that net. Got a good grip on it, sir. Sure give one a hit.
You want to be a big shot and get your name on Broadway, don't you?
Yes.
How do you suppose Ruth Roland, Helen Holmes, and Pearl White became stars?
By having doubles at $5 a day.
Yeah. No. By being brave.
Was that up there?
Okay, Chief, she's raring to go.
Good.
Woo! Marsh, don't jump! Don't jump! Ow! Ow!
Ah! You're a game kid. But we're going to slip you an extra five for this.
Ooh, I wish somebody had slipped me a cushion.
That was a very good leap, Miss Clancy. Very good.
Well, at least I made a good impression.
All right, on your feet, everybody. Come on, next location.
All right, bring that truck down here.
Hold that camera car. Bring it down here, boys.
Hurry up, boys.
The villain is off stage. You asking, who are you and where do you come from? Did you get it?
Okay.
Bill, come home to your mother and me.
Turn him over, Bill.
Who are you and where do you come from?
Why, I'm Joe Dilts from Piperville. I'm looking for Marge Clancy.
Cut! Get off this set, you big son!
Who, me? Well, I'm sorry.
Do you mind if I use your phone?
Go ahead.
Operator?
Oh, this doesn't work. You mind telling me where I can use a real phone?
Go down the hall and turn to your left. And you'll find a sign marked Mr. Ginsburg. You'll find a real phone there.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Oh, thank you so much.
Oh. I brought something back here. Oh, my, send me that soaping jar. Oh, man. What are you doing in here?
I'm looking for my sweetheart, Marge.
Oh, Marge. Why, she's right behind that screen.
Here I am, honey.
Who's that calling me, honey?
Why, that isn't her. You know, I came all the way from Piperville. I'm looking for Marge Clancy.
Oh, Marge Clancy. Well, you'll find her at the third door down the line.
She doesn't know that I'm out here.
Does your mother know you're out?
Oh, yes. I told her where I was going.
For goodness sake. Goosey?
No, Clancy. Marge.
Margie. Here I am. Where are you?
Don't be afraid, Joe. Lions. They didn't hurt Daniel, so they can't hurt you. And roars can't hurt you. Cut! Oh, please, it might have been a real bullet. Too bad it wasn't.
Marge, can you tell me where I can find Miss Clancy?
Oh, Miss Clancy? Right in the contract department.
Thank you.
Oh. Thank you. Oh!
Thank you.
You've got the wrong sign on that door.
Oh, Marge! What are you doing up there? I'm waiting for scene number 746.
Okay.
I failed again, eh? You won't thwart me this time.
Listen, how much did that scene run?
This is going a little too far.
Oh, it was only 20 feet. All right, everybody down the boulevard for the next scene.
Hey, you. Wait a minute.
Oh, please, my man. Charlie and I have a luncheon engagement.
Who?
Charlie. He's in the car.
Oh, he is. I'm sorry. A dummy.
I told you we should have used Marion Davies.
You ought to be arrested.
Oh, I didn't mean any harm, but I'm looking for my girl, and she works in a studio.
No! No!
Oh, Marge! There she goes! Marge! They're kidnapping her! Get out of my way! I'll be there, Marge!
Thank you.
Mack, listen, we all love you. Now, don't do it.
Thank you. been frying fish?
No, just running up the scale. Say, listen to the new one I just learned.
Oh, look, they can find. It's that bum upstairs. He will take a bath in that wash bowl. Wait till I get a hold of him taking showers in that wash bowl all the time. Open the door.
Yes, ma'am. Good morning.
What's going on here? You... Say, what are you trying to do? Take a shower bath in that bowl? Well, I'm no geranium. I don't need watering. Look here. You promised me my rent for a week back.
Why, I never knew you had a week back.
Oh, so you're going to smart crack me, are you? Well, I'll show you a thing or two. Mike! 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 Oh, Mike!
What's the matter, baby?
I want you to come up here and see this guy about his rent. I'll show you, young man.
So, this is the buzzard that you've been telling me about.
Before I pay my rent, I have a kick coming.
You have a kick coming?
Yes.
Did you hear that, darling? He says that he has a kick coming. Well, you have a kick coming. Well, here it is. And we'll hold your trunk till you dig up the rent.
You bet we will.
You have hurt my feelings. How would you like to make a quarter?
Who do I have to kill?
No, you don't understand. All you have to do is move a trunk.
Move a trunk? For a quarter, I'll move the whole elephant.
Follow me.
What a very idea. Take that trunk and get it out of this house this minute. Take it right out of this house, you hear me? Get it out. Get it out. Come on, as fast as you can. You can't put anything over on me.
Just run home, baby. It won't be long now. Come on.
Well, leaving town?
Oh, Geno. He's helping me move. We're college chums.
Say, don't I know you?
Never met you before.
It seems to me that I remember the cell that you occupied last summer.
What I won't do to you if I get you!
Mr. Poston.
Yes?
How shall we know Judge Brown?
Well, the only description I have of him is that he's very eccentric and a great golf enthusiast.
Oh, isn't that grand?
Splendid.
Oh,
so easy to understand.
Back.
There he is now. See him?
Even the dogs recognize him.
Oh, Judge. Judge Brown.
Judge Brown.
Well, Judge Brown. Welcome to our city. We're delighted to see you, I'm sure, Judge. This is the ladies of our committee, Judge. Will you allow me? Please. Thank you. There you are. How's that? And now, Judge, may I present you with the key to our city hall.
Yeah.
Oh, thank you. I can sleep there tonight.
Cuddy, buddy, don't believe me. Yes. Ladies, you'll excuse us. The judge will ride with me. We have few things to talk about. Huh? Right this way, judge. Right this way, judge.
I do hope my dog is first size.
Mother always said I'd go to the dog.
Very clever.
You're right.
Yes, quite clever, yeah. Oh, by the way, there's Mr. Ramsey. I want you to meet Mr. Ramsey. He's our ring steward. Yeah, come right this way, Judge.
Oh, Mr. Ramsey.
Yes,
Mr. Ramsey, please.
Yes, Ramsey?
Judge Brown. Judge, delighted.
Get out.
He's an eccentric, Judge. Oh, Judge.
Yes.
I leave you with the ring steward. Don't forget my wife's prize. Blue ribbon.
Leave it to me.
Well, Judge. See you later.
See you later.
How do you do, Judge?
Why, how do you do? Get there.
Come on, Judge.
Hello, how are you?
Hi. I'm sorry my dogs won't be in the show, but they got the mane.
That's nothing. My puppies have corn. Not so bad.
Oh, look. That's one of them Mexican dogs.
Those dogs die very happy.
How?
Why, their hair grows inward and tickles them to death.
What makes that dog so close to the ground?
He was born under a bureau.
Say, listen. You give my police dog first prize, you hear me?
Uh-oh.
All right, folks, we're now going to award the prizes. The first on the platform will be the Junior Wire-Haired Terrier, number 40. Number 42, 44, 49, and 50.
Aren't they cute? I love animals.
The first three. Examine them.
Business. You're going to win the first prize with your police dog.
All right, Scottish Terrier. 53, 54, 55, and 59. Place your dog right around the platform.
Say, isn't that a funny looking bunch? I want to tell you something. I bet you there's a pig amongst them.
Shh, not so loud. They're Scotch. Don't forget. The last three.
Lady, first prize.
Oh, thank you, Judge.
Yeah. Second prize.
Second prize.
Thank you, Judge.
You're welcome.
Third prize.
Third prize.
Thank you.
If my dog had teeth, I'd make him bite you.
If he's a judge, I'm Little Red Riding Hood.
He knew that dog the minute he saw it, didn't he? That's his style. Gets comedy out of his work.
Now, folks, next we'll have the police dog. The police dog, 63, 65, 67, and 70.
Dog. You know, I like that dog. Is this your dog? You know, I like dogs.
Do you?
Yes, I do. You know, I personally like you. I have something for you. Wait. I award you the first prize.
Thank you.
All right, I'll be seeing you.